So we'll sometimes want to talk about whether a function is increasing, decreasing, or constant. Once you get to calculus, you'll figure out other ways to do it, but for now we're going to take a look at our graph that I've given you and just describe it. So one of the important things to remember is you're describing or you're looking at the y behavior, but your answer is the interval of x's over which that is happening. So we always walk left to right, and you can think of it as walking uphill, downhill, or constant. Okay? So if your function is increasing, that means each subsequent y value is bigger than the one before. So the question might read, over what intervals is this function, and we'll call it, right, it's the function f of x, over which intervals is the function f of x increasing? And so we look for places where if we're walking, we would be walking uphill. So you can see that if we go right here on the graph, right, that little guy is going to walk uphill from x equals negative 5. So it's an interval, so I'll use the interval notation. From negative 5, I'm going to use a bracket there. It's closed in circle, right? If you wanted to have an argue about whether you can be increasing there or not, I'm willing to have it when you get to calculus, but not here. For now, well, if it's a solid dot, we do a closed bracket on our interval. And we walk uphill all the way till we get to negative 2, when x is negative 2, right? These are always x values. That was an open circle, so I'll go ahead and put a parenthesis on my negative 2. No other places am I walking uphill. Every place else does something different, such as here between negative 2 and positive 1 on that interval of x values. We would describe that behavior, so negative 2 to positive 1. For these x's, my y values are constant, exactly, not up or down, nice and flat. And then we have nothing between 1 and 2. I know it's over a little bit, but that's okay. So between 2, right, something new happens, and I've stuck a little arrow on there. That means it does this behavior for the, right, till infinity. And for the x's between 2 and infinity, we're always going down. Each subsequent y value is smaller than the one before, is further down. So we call that decreasing. Okay. So x intervals describing the y behavior.